Gabriel, for you, how difficult was it to, as I'm saying, it's the first time you're working with seasoned actors or people, you're looking around set, everything's up. What was the biggest challenge for you on set?
The biggest challenge for me, I think, was bringing Janelle to life. In terms of, well, I know the dialogue in and of itself, how she spoke, her mannerisms, you know, little things she would do. That was the biggest challenge for me. I mean, Nadine had to bring in Scantana to come and give me some lessons and, you know, switch up a bit in the script, like change a few words, make it more Jamaican. Because, well, I grew up in a household, the typical Jamaican household where, you know, patois is seen as speaking bad.
Right.
So it didn't come naturally to
me. Okay.
And so I think that was my biggest challenge. Also, the kiss.
Yes.
Was a big challenge, you know, first time on camera. Jovi and I are just meeting a couple weeks in. We never rehearsed it before that time.
You never rehearsed? Oh my God.
Rehearsed.
So a little bit of the awkwardness
was
real.
It was a bit awkward. I mean, but we had good direction from Nadine. She gave us a couple exercises to do to try and get that connection going right before.
Yeah. Nadine gave you good direction for a kiss.
Yeah, she
we're going to talk about that.
Right before they were setting up the scene, they were like, the two directors came in and said, guys, can we talk to you? We heard that you guys haven't practiced this
kiss. Yeah.
So we're like, no, we haven't. We got this. They're like,
we're just gonna try and wing it.
So we winged it. We did wing it, and
I don't know. I think it worked out.
You
like,
winged it.
We
didn't want it to be ugly. Like
yeah.
We wanted it to come out good on screen.
We wanted it to be beautiful and look authentic.
And
you know, because the guys on the set kept on like, oh, so that part is coming up now, huh?
Yeah, everybody wants to get that.
So that part.
It was a closed set.
Yeah, so we had a closed set. Because Gabriel and I were just kind of like,
as it should be.
And we weren't joking. Every time they made a joke, we're just like, we don't find you funny. Like, we're serious and just leave. And like, so, but we had a closed set and we got the shot.
Yeah.
We got the shot.
Were you worried about how people would receive it?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Both of us were worried. I think Jovi more so than I was. But we both were a bit anxious and concerned about how people would receive it. But, I mean, overall, it was a good film. It was a good story. And, I mean, that wasn't the focal point of it.
Absolutely.
There were so many aspects of it to appreciate. So.
Absolutely, and I think now that everyone's seen it, and now that everyone's seen it and you've heard the reception, I'm sure you both went, okay, we're good. Okay.
A big sigh of relief when I saw it.
Yeah. Jovi, what did you think when you saw it?
Well, I just think, you know, it's 2020 and we're acting and we're portraying real life as we're acting. And a lot of people, this is their life.
This is their life.
And it's just...
capturing the real emotion.
It's just capturing that emotion and, you know, helping people go through... people going through different things. I mean, you know, it's just don't take yourself so seriously. You know, we're practicing art, and this
I
is
have
a part
to say
of the
that a lot of the success, the ultimate success of this short film, has to do with the directors because and there are two. There's Gareth and Nadine, and they treated everything they treated the material with respect.
Okay.
And they treated the actors with respect, and I think the sensitive scene that you've been speaking about was handled very delicately and truthfully. And I think, in fact, I think that is what you can say for the whole film. It does come off as truthful, at least to me.
Yeah,
when I saw it, I was very pleased.
That's one of the things for me. I thought the emotions were truthful, the relationships, just about everything that happened in this one event.